Although the coming of the ChatGPT has brought a lot of enjoyment to very many people, including the students, the general public, so many people have raised concerns over the use of the ChatGPT. People are using it unethically. For example, the institutions, academia. Now, it has literally been banned in so many fields. So, in the academic field, it has been cited that people have begun or are more likely to use the ChatGPT to write articles or academic papers or do assignments in schools. And so many institutions such as the New York Education has come up and has banned the use of the ChatGPT in academic writing or in any form of education. In fact, they in Europe itself, they have blocked the use of the website, citing the issue relating to students using it for other purposes, going to reduce creativity and so many other aspects. Even sites such as the Stackoverflow, which is a site that programmers always use to share information. So if you get stuck with writing a code, if you're developing something, you can actually use Stack Overflow to post in your question, and then other programmers can write for your responses. Now, it has been cited that over the last few months, because of the ChatGPT's ability to generate for you some codes that tend to look to be correct, many people are posting codes that are literally not functional because they believe that what ChatGPT has produced, it's actually functional. So it has been banned in so many sites. Now, to counteract this, an app or a website known as the GPTZero, which is indicating that we do not need any GPT related item in our work, has been developed. Now, GPTZero aims to differentiate work or pieces of article or blogs or writings that has either been written by a human being or it has been written by an artificial intelligence. Now, this site was designed by a student called Edward Tian. Now, Edward from Princeton designed this app and it is under development right now, and it has really been released officially around the 5th or the 6th of January, which is by the time this video was recorded. Now, many people have raised both appreciating the coming up with this program, especially people who are seeing the use of the ChatGPT for unethical issues. The academic people are happy with this and other general public. And how the GPTZero will work is that its aim is going to scan an article or a piece of work or a piece of writing, and it is going to try to consider its complexity. So if it's very complex, it can easily distinguish whether it is a human being who has written this or it is an AI which has written it. So with that, if it's an exam or if it is a research article, it can literally check for that one. Of course, still many people are claiming that this is not a very good move, because if you want to eliminate the use of the AI in helping us or aiding us in writing other items such as academic work or answering our daily day-to-day questions or writing blog posts and the rest, then you should have eliminated sites such as Grammarly, that we right now use them to correct our grammar, to paraphrase, to check for plagiarism or remove even plagiarism, all that kind of stuff. So they're claiming that we are already using the plagiarism checkers and all those other online grammar correcting tools, which are already AI. So it is not really important right now to ban the use of the ChatGPT. Of course, it's still a very strong debate. Yep, and the restrictions are really tight in a number. If you look at this example here, this was an exam instruction, and it clearly indicated that chatbots such as the ChatGPT are not allowed in the exam room. So the academic people are really, really serious against the ChatGPT. So what do you think? Is it a revolution Do you think the GPT-Zero can provide a solution? Okay, can it provide that barrier? Can it against the unethical use of the ChatGPT? Do you think it's going to counteract the ChatGPT itself? Me personally, well, the ChatGPT is a great tool, and I think if one uses it for the rightful purposes, then they can really achieve a lot from it. But I'm waiting to see where the GPT-Zero goes. Of course, they have already launched a demo, and they have tried to use them on a number of posts, like on Twitter and a number of social media, to try to distinguish whether what has been posted or what was posted by those media or different companies were human written or they were AI written. And well, the results, they have not officially released it, but right now, if you go on the official site for the GPT-Zero, you can only be able to sign up for the newsletter and just read a few areas. And many people, to show that many people are excited over the coming up of the GPT-Zero, just over its launch, which was launched by around 5th or 6th January, around that, the site crashed, the app itself crashed, because of so many people that tried to sign up at the same time. It had so much high web traffic in that it had to crash, and so they have to go back and redevelop it again, or readjust a few things here and there. So right now you can only sign up for newsletters to give you updates, but you cannot begin using it commercially or officially. But let's wait and see where the GPT-Zero goes. See you next time. Subscribe.